Good afternoon, dear learners, dear everyone, to the 13th lesson in our course, Teaching English for Beginners. At the beginning, allow me to introduce my partner, Miss Lujain Hassan. Good afternoon, Lujain.
Good afternoon, Mr. Ogoli. Good afternoon, everyone.
Well, we are going to start as usual with some slides revising the previous lesson. This is our 13th lesson, the revision of some pictures, how do you get to school. I take a bus, so we can go to school taking a bus, or we can take a taxi. So either we take a bus or we take a taxi. Or, Lujain?
You can ride a bike or you can walk. So, I ride a bike, I walk.
So when someone asks you, how do you get to school, you can say, I take a bus, or I take a taxi, or I ride a bike, or I walk. Simply, I walk. Now, we have directions. We have on the left, we have straight ahead, and we have on the right. To give directions, we can say, go straight ahead, then we say, it is on the left or it is on the right. We have some directions, like in the pictures to the left, on the corner. On the corner, and the second picture is next to. Next to. Lujain. Where is the bookstore?
It's on the corner.
And where is the policeman?
He's next to the police car. Where's the bookstore?
It's on the corner.
And where is the policeman?
He is next to the police car. Now we have opposite the park. Opposite, as I said last time, in America they say across from. So across from means opposite. We have between, opposite and between. Where is your building, Lujain?
It's opposite the park.
And where's the cat?
Between the girl and the boy. Where is the building?
It's opposite the park.
And where is the cat?
It's between the boy and the girl. Then we have behind and we have near. Where is the girl?
She's behind the wall.
And where's the boy?
He's near the tree. Where's the girl?
She's behind the wall.
And where is the boy?
He is near the tree. Now we have an exercise to check if you remember the names of these things. Look at the picture and tell. Is it a camera or a watch? Lujain?
Well, right, it's a watch.
It's a watch. And this is?
A camera.
A camera. Camera. And this is?
Yes, a purse.
It's a purse. Purse. And this is?
A wallet.
A wallet. Wallet. And these are
glasses.
Glasses. Glasses. And these are
sunglasses.
Sunglasses. What are these? These are credit cards. Credit cards. And this is Jane.
Passport.
Passport. Now, choose the correct preposition. I live for or in the city center?
Well, I live in the city center.
In the city center. Number two, Lujain, will you say it?
I don't live in or with a flat.
It's in. In a flat. I don't live in a flat. The third one, I don't live in or with my grandparents. Here, we live with somebody, but in a building. So it is with my grandparents. With my grandparents. Jane?
I work in or with a school. Correct. It's in a school.
I work in or for Microsoft. I work for Microsoft. Now we come to parts of the body. Parts of the body. As you can see from the arrows, top left, ear. Then we have nose. Then we have mouth. Then we have hand. Then at the bottom we have knee. Now top right, Eugene.
We have head, eye, arm, leg, foot.
Well, now question words. When you ask a question, you need to know which question word to use. We use what for things. What to ask about things. And we use who for people. To ask about people, we use who. We use where for place. To ask about a place, we use where. And when for time. Why for reason. And how many for number. Will you say them again, Eugene?
So, what for things, who for people, where for place, when for time, why for reason, how many for number.
Well, now we are going to use the question words in conversation or in full questions. What do you do? What do you do means what's your job? What do you do, Lejane?
I'm a student.
Who lives with you?
I live with my parents.
And where do you live?
I live in Damascus.
When do you go to the market?
Well, I go to the market maybe on Fridays.
Good. Why are you crying?
Because I lost a mark in the exam.
And how many brothers and sisters do you have?
I have a brother and a sister.
Very nice.
إننا لنا شكون إسمعوا يا حاضرون إننا لنا شكون. قد سهلنا قد تعبنا لكن أبدا ما مللنا ما مللنا قد سهلنا قد تعبنا لكن أبدا ما مللنا ما مللنا للأمام سائرون للمعالي صاعدون ناجحون ناجحون إننا لناجحون اجتهدنا الليل قمنا ما وهمنا بل عزمنا اجتهدنا الليل قمنا على المجال صابرا قمما الفخار صاعدون ناجحون ناجحون إننا لناجحون في الليالي أين كنا سائلوه التقييم عنا في الليالي كنا سائلون التقييم عنا للفناء تاركون للكتاب قارئون ناجحون ناجحون إننا لناجحون ناجحون ناجحون إننا لناجحون اسمعوا يا حاضرون إننا لناجحون ناجحون ناجحون إننا لناجحون اسمعوا يا حاضرون إننا لناجحون
Hi again. We are so sorry for this error and we continue from where we stopped. I was telling how to say the numbers 100, 200, 300, 150, 275, 1000. Eugene, will you say them?
100, 200, 300, 150, 275, 1,000.
Well, 2,000, 2,200, 20,000, 300,000, 27,500, 350,000.
2,000, 2,200, 20,000, 300,000, 27,500, 350,000.
I hope it is clear. We come to vocabulary about adjectives. We have two new words, poor and rich. Poor is opposite of rich. To know the meaning of poor and rich, we put two men. One is poor, without money, and the other is rich. He has a lot of money. So poor, no money, rich, a lot of money. Now we have two girls. One is
beautiful.
Beautiful. Very nice. She is very beautiful. And the other is
ugly.
Ugly. Again, these two adjectives are opposite of each other. Beautiful, ugly. Now look, we have three children. Happy, happy, laughing. They are happy. And the little boy is sad. Dangerous, safe, we don't fear about anything. Dangerous, this little boy following the chasing the ball may be run over by the car. He may be run over by the car. So safe and dangerous. Then we have two opposite to each other adjectives, fast and slow. The boy is fast, but the turtle or the tortoise is slow. Actually, the turtle is the one who lives, which lives in the sea, and the tortoise, the one which lives on the land. Now look, we have difficult and easy. Difficult and easy. The exercise with the girl is difficult, but the exercise with the boy is easy. Simple, easy. Then we have quiet. Quiet means no noise, no cars, no too many people. So it's quiet. Busy, the street is busy. It means we have a lot of cars, a lot of people, a lot of noise. So quiet and busy. Now we have vocabulary about nouns. Lujane, we have two pictures of
a servant and a housewife. Servant.
Servant and a housewife. The servant is the one who serves you in a restaurant or at home. The housewife is the mother who doesn't work, only works in the house, housewife. Now, we have to talk about pronunciation. Breakfast, breakfast, quarter, quarter, stomach. Stomach. I have breakfast at 7 o'clock.
It's 11:15.
She has a stomach ache.
She was Queen of England.
Cars were very slow.
Driving wasn't safe.
Well, we move. We are going to read a story. Then we are going to answer the questions. First, we start with tone. Things were very different when we were poor, and life was very difficult. Sometimes there wasn't much food, and sometimes we were hungry. There was no school in the village. We worked on the farm. There were 9 children in the family. Our house was very small. Will you read it again, Lujane?
Tom said, things were very different when we were poor, and life was very difficult. Sometimes there wasn't much food, and sometimes we were hungry. There was no school in the village. We worked on the farm. There were 9 children in the family. Our house was very small.
Now, Helen. Helen says, My father was very rich, and we lived in a big house. There were 10 bedrooms and a beautiful garden. There were lots of servants. I wasn't happy because I didn't have any brothers or sisters. Liu Jane.
My father was very rich, and we lived in a big house. There were 10 bedrooms and a beautiful garden. There were lots of servants. I wasn't happy because I didn't have any brothers or sisters.
Okay, now we are going to do this exercise. We are going to say a sentence and you learners are going to guess who said it. Number one, I was very rich. Tom or Helen?
Helen.
It's Helen. Helen said I was very rich. The second one, Lu Jane?
I was very poor.
Tom. Tom. The third one, I had a big family.
Tom.
Tom. I was an only child.
Helen.
Only means doesn't have brothers or sisters. So it is
Helen.
Helen. Helen didn't have brothers or sisters. Eugene, the following one.
My house was very small.
Tom. My house was very small. It was Tom who said that. We worked on a farm. Again, it's Tom. I had a beautiful garden.
It's Helen.
Helen. Right. Now, grammar, past of verb to be. It's kind of revision. Was she happy?
Yes, she was. Or no, she wasn't.
Now, were his parents rich?
Yes, they were. Or no, they weren't.
Yes, they were. Or no, they weren't. What was his job?
He was a student.
And where were they from?
They were from, and you can say whatever you want.
Yes, from England, from Syria, from whatever you want to say about these people. Conversation. Were you nice to your brothers and sisters?
Yes, I think I was.
What subject were you good at?
I was good at maths.
What was your favorite game?
It was basketball.
When was your favorite food? What was your favorite food?
Oh, I can't remember. Were you nice to your brothers and sisters?
Yes, I think I was.
And what subject were you good at?
I was good at maths.
What was your favorite game?
It was basketball.
What was your favorite food?
Oh, I can't remember. Now, we come to irregular verbs. We are going to talk about the past form of some irregular verbs. As you know, we make the past of a regular verb by adding ed to the verb. But some irregular verbs, we need to learn them by heart. Make, the past of make is?
Made.
Made. And the past of leave?
Left.
Left. Have?
Had.
Sell?
Sold.
Meet?
Met.
And go?
Went.
Went. Become? Became?
Make? Made.
Leave? Left.
Have? Had.
Sell? Sold.
Meet? Met.
Go? Went. Now we are going to put these words in sentences. I'm going to read the first one. Chanel's clothes became popular in 1920s.
Charlie Chaplin made his first film in 1914.
In 1952, Charlie Chaplin left the USA and went to live in Switzerland.
Bob Marley had a son, Ziggy Marley.
Vincent van Gogh sold only one painting in his life.
Bob Marley met the Beatles in 1975.
So, You see how we used these words in sentences? Chanel's clothes became popular in the 1920s. Charlie Chaplin made his first film in 1914. In 1952, Charlie Chaplin left the USA and went to live in Switzerland.
Bob Marley had a son, Ziggy Marley. Vincent van Gogh sold only one painting in his life. Bob Marley met the Beatles in 1975.
The Beatles is the name of a band of singers. This band was very famous in the 1970s. We have a reading text. J.K. Rowling was born in England in 1965. She loved reading and wrote her first story, Rabbit, when she was only 6 years old. She studied French at university, then worked as a secretary in London. She had the idea of Harry Potter when she was on a train. "Harry just walked into my head," she said later. She started writing the first Harry Potter book the next day.
J.K. Rowling was born in England in 1965. She loved reading and wrote her first story, Rabbit, when she was only 6 years old. She studied French at university, then worked as a secretary in London. She had the idea of Harry Potter when she was on a train. "Harry just walked into my head," she said later. She started writing the first Harry Potter book the next day.
In 1992, she went to live in Portugal for 3 years. She wrote Harry Potter in the morning and worked as an English teacher in the afternoon and evening. She got married to a Portuguese TV journalist and had a daughter called Jessica. Then she returned to England and lived in Edinburgh in Scotland. She was unemployed at that time and wrote in cafes because they were warmer than her small flat.
In 1992, she went to live in Portugal for 3 years. She wrote Harry Potter in the morning and worked as an English teacher in the afternoon and evening. She got married to a Portuguese TV journalist and had a daughter called Jessica. Then she returned to England and lived in Edinburgh in Scotland. She was unemployed at that time and wrote in cafes because they were warmer than her small flat.
After 5 years, she finished the first book, Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone. The book sold millions of copies all over the world, and Joanne Kathleen Rowling became very famous. She is now very rich, but she still writes her books in cafes.
After 5 years, she finished the first book, Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone. The book sold millions of copies all over the world, and Joanne Kathleen Rowling became very famous. She is now very rich, but she still writes her books in cafes.
Just before we move to the questions, I want to clarify something. As I told you when we were saying the numbers, when we have a number before 100, 1,000, million, we don't put S. We say 300, 3,000, 4 million. But if we don't have a number before them, we can add S. We can say millions, like you saw here in the text. The book sold millions of copies. Here we don't have a number before million, so we can say millions. Now we go to the questions. Answer the following questions about the text. Where and when was J.K. Rowling born? Can you remember?
J.K. Rowling was born in England in 1965.
Right. And what was the name of her first story?
Well, it was Rabbit.
Rabbit, right. And what did she study at university?
She studied French.
She studied French. We continue. What was her job after she finished university?
She worked as a secretary.
She worked as a secretary. How long did she live in Portugal?
She lived in Portugal for 3 years.
3 years. And what was her job in Portugal?
She worked as a teacher.
She worked as a teacher. How long did it take her to finish her first book in Edinburgh?
It took her 5 years.
It took her 5 years. Why did she write in cafes?
Because they were warmer than her small flat.
Grammar and but. Now we are going to talk about and but. Look at this example. Alison left her job as a teacher and became a writer. So we use and to join two similar things. We don't have contrasting. Two similar things, things that happen one after another. Then we have another example. We argued a lot, but we were a good team. Here we have contrast, two different things. We use but to join two different things. Eugene.
Alison left her job as a teacher and became a writer. So we use and to join two similar things. Another example. We argued a lot, but we were a good team. So we use but to join two different things.
Now, we are going to choose, as learners, which one is correct, and or but. The first one, Tom is married and but he has two children.
And,
yes, we don't have contrast here. Contrast means one different than the other, different from the other. So here we have information, one following the other. We don't have any kind of contrast. So Tom is married and he has two children. Lujane.
She looked for her pen everywhere and or but she didn't find it. Correct, but.
But. She looked for her pen everywhere but she didn't find it. Mary went to Egypt on holiday and or but had a great time.
And.
Mary went to Egypt on holiday and had a great time. Blue Jane.
This is a good hotel and or but the rooms are very quiet. Can you guess?
And.
Correct. It's and.
This is a good hotel and the rooms are very quiet. I can play the piano and or but I can't sing.
Correct. It's but.
But. Here we have contrast. Two different things. I can play the piano, but I can't sing. We come again to vocabulary. We have the train. So this vocabulary is going to be about train. Train. And then we have single ticket. We have two kinds of tickets. Single means one way. Or return ticket, it means you go and return with the same ticket. So the price is more than the single ticket, but you can use the ticket twice. You can go, do what you want to do there, and you come back with the same ticket. It is called a return ticket. Single means one way. So train and single ticket. Ticket office is where you buy tickets before you take the train. Now we have the return ticket. This kind of ticket can be used twice. You go to your destination. Destination means the place you want to go to. The place you want or the city you want to go to is your destination. Now we have
platform, platform, and the train station.
Yes, the platform is where you stand to take the train, to get onto the train. The platform is the place where you stand to get onto the train. The train station is the whole area which contains the passengers, the buildings, and the trains, and the train track. Now, we come to conversation. Can I have a return to Oxford, please?
Okay, that's 23.50 euro.
This is pound. Sorry. Okay, here you are. What time is the next train?
Well, there is one at 9:30.
Oh, good. Which platform?
Platform 10.
Okay, thanks a lot. Bye.
Can I have a return to Oxford, please?
Okay, that's £23.50.
Here you are. What time is the next train?
Well, there is one at 9:30.
Oh, good. Which platform?
Platform 10.
Okay, thanks a lot. Bye.
Kind of revision. Hi, my name is Oscar White.
I'm Pamela Richard.
It's nice to meet you, Pamela.
Nice to meet you too.
I'm sorry, what was your last name again?
It's White. Well, hi, my name is Oscar White.
I'm Pamela Richard.
It's nice to meet you, Pamela.
Nice to meet you too.
I'm sorry, what was your last name again?
It's White. What's your name?
I'm Sara Ismail.
Is it S-A-R-A-H?
Yes, that's right.
How do you spell your last name? E-S-M-A-E-L?
No, it's I-S-M-A-E-L. What's your name?
I'm Sara Ismail.
Is it S-A-R-A-H?
Yes, that's right.
And how do you spell your last name? E-S-M-A-E-L?
No, it's I-S-M-A-E-L. Now, how to spell some names. George, it's G-E-O-R-G-E.
Joan, G-O-H-N.
Anthony, A-N-T-H-O-N-Y.
Elizabeth, E-L-I-Z-A-B-E-T-H.
Christopher, C-H-R-I-S-T-O-P-H-E-R.
Catherine, K-A-T-H-E-R-I-N-E.
Michael, it is written like Mikhail in French, it's Michel. Some countries say Mikhail. In Britain and America, it's Michael. Michael, M-I-C-H-A-E-L. Now, we move to some names and nicknames. Nicknames means the short names. For males, we have Anthony, Tony. The nickname of Anthony is Tony. Christopher, usually people whose name is Christopher are called Chris. Michael, Mike. Joshua, Josh. Matthew, Matt. Will you say them?
So for males, Anthony, Tony, Christopher, Chris, Mike, Joshua, Josh, Matthew, Matt.
Okay. Now, for females, Elizabeth, Beth, Catherine, Kathy, Jennifer, Jen, Nicole, Nikki, Susan, Sue.
For females, Elizabeth, Beth, Catherine, Kathy, Jennifer, Jen, Nicole, Nikki, Suzanne, Sue.
Sue. Well, greeting. Hi, Matthew. How are you?
Great. How about you, Beth?
I'm very well, thanks.
Good morning, Mr. Brown. How are you?
I'm just fine, Tony. Thank you.
Hi, Matthew. How are you?
Great. How about you, Beth?
I'm very well, thanks.
Good morning, Mr. Brown. How are you?
I'm just fine, Tony. Thank you.
Good afternoon, Lisa. How are you?
Not bad, thanks. How are you?
I'm very well, thanks.
Good morning, Mr. Brown. How are you?
Hello, Miss Richard. Ms. Richard, how are you?
I'm okay, thank you. Good afternoon, Lisa. How are you?
Not bad, thanks. How are you?
I am very well, thanks.
Good evening, Mrs. Brown. How are you?
Hello, Ms. Richard. How are you?
I'm okay, thank you. Like this, we come to the end of our lesson for today. We hope you have got benefit from it. Until we see you next time, we both, Lujain Hassan and I, wish you all the best. Thank you and bye-bye.